गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. आई एम केवी भिक्षमय्या, लेक्चरर इन जुआलजी, गवर्नमेंट डिग्री कॉलेज, गंभीरावपेट, राजन सिरसिल्ल. सब्जेक्ट जुआलजी, टॉपिक फ्रॉग नर्व सिस्टम. Frog have a highly developed nervous system that consists of a brain, spinal cord and a nerve. Many parts of frog brains corresponding with those of humans. It consists of two olfactory lobes, two cerebral hemispheres, a final body, two optic lobes, a cerebellum and a medulla oblongata. The nervous system of a frog is composed of three main subdivisions. They are central nervous system and peripheral nervous system and autonomous nervous system. The central nervous system connect with the brain and spinal cord. Peripheral nervous system connect with the cranial and spinal nerves. And autonomous nervous system connect with the systematic and parasympathetic nervous system. Next we discuss about this. The brain is located inside the cranium. First of all, we discuss frog brain. The brain is located inside the cranium. Brain is covered by two meninges, namely inner and perimeter and outer diameters. To the brain of the frog is divisible into the three parts. They are forebrain and midbrain and inbrain. Now we discuss forebrain. It is the anterior part of the brain that includes olfactory lobes, cerebral and hemispheres and diencephalon. Olfactory lobes anterior the forebrain is produced into two lobes called olfactory lobes. They are responsible for the sense of smell. Each olfactory lobes contains a cavity called rhinocerebellum. Cerebral hemispheres. Behind the olfactory lobes, there are two large lobes called the cerebral hemispheres or cerebrum. The roof of the cerebrum is hemmed. It is called pilonium. The ventrolateral valves in the thick net and are all called corpora striata. The corpora striata have the two sides and are the connected by a transverse tract of fibres called anterior ligaments. And part of forebrain, third part is diencephalon. The diencephalon lies posterior part. The diencephalon lies in the posterior to the cerebral hemispheres on the dorsal side of the diencephalon. There is a small projection called epiphysis. Attached to the epiphysis, there is a small knob-like structure called final body. like structure called phenol body. In the halal frog, the phenol body separates from the epiphyses and comes to lies outside the skull. It is the vestige of the third lies, brow and spot. The dorsal wall of the dinoceptolon is non-nervous and vascular. And it is folded inwards, forming the interior choroid and plexus. The ventral side of the dinoceptolon bears an X-shaped structure called a haptic chiasma. The haptic chiasma is formed by the optic nervous just behind the optic chiasma. There is a projection called infundibulum. The infundibulum carries our oval body called the hypophysis. The infundibulum and the hypophysis together form the pituitary gland. Next, the floor of the cavity of dinoceptolon is called hypothalamus. The floor of the cavity of dinoceptolon is called hypothalamus. The lateral walls of the dinoceptolon become thick to form the optic thalami. This is the forebrain. Next, we discuss midbrain. It contains a pair of hollow oval bodies called optic lobes, as the optic lobes are two in number. They are called corpora bigeminia. Next, the floor of midbrain is thickened into a pair of fibrous tracts called a crura cerebri. The floor of midbrain is thickened into a pair of fibrous tract called crura cerebri. They connect the forebrain and midbrain. Forebrain and midbrain. This is the midbrain of functions. Next, hindbrain. It consists of the cerebellum and medulla oblongata. It consists of cerebellum and medulla oblongata. Cerebellum. It is a poorly developed narrow transverse solid bond placed just behind the optic lobes. Once again, it is a poorly developed narrow transverse solid bond placed just behind the optic lobes. Next up, medulla oblongata. Medulla oblongata. It is the last small part of the brain. What is the last small part of the brain? Medulla oblongata is the last small part of the brain. It is triangular in shape and is posterior continued as spinal cord. Posterior continues as spinal cord. The roop of medulla oblongata is non-nervous and vascular. It is called posterior choroid plexus. Choroidal plexus. Next, we discuss about ventricles of brain. Ventricles of brain. The cavity next to his discussion forebrain is part in olfactory lobes, cerebral hemispheres and diencephala, and midbrain and hindbrain. Hindbrain is two parts, cerebellum and medulla oblongata. Next we discuss ventricles of brains. The cavity enclosed by the brain is called ventricles. The cavity enclosed by the brain is called ventricles. There are four ventricles in the brain. They are 1, 2, 3, and 4 ventricles. One and two ventricles are located inside the cerebrum. There are four second and first and second ventricles are located inside the cerebrum. They are also called lateral ventricles or pharyngeal. Pharyngeal. Second, first and second ventricles. And next, third ventricles lies inside the diencephalon. Third ventricle lies inside the diencephalon. It is also called diocele. It is also called diocele. This is the only third ventricle. It communicates with first and second ventricles by two opening called foramen of Monroe. Foramen of Monroe. Next, the fourth ventricle is present inside the medulla oblongata. It is also called metacele. It is also called metacele. The fourth ventricle is also called metacele. Third and fourth ventricles are connected by a narrow canal called ileum. Narrow canal called ileum or aqueduct of Clavius. Aqueduct of Clavius lying in the midbrain. Lying in the midbrain. This is the fourth ventricles of the ventricle of the brain. First of all, we discuss central nervous system and peripheral nervous system and autonomous nervous system. Central nervous system parts in brain and spinal cord. Peripheral nervous system parts of in cranial and spinal nervous and autonomous nervous system and some sympathetic and parasympathetic nerves. The brain is called inside the, first of all you discuss about the brain. First, we draw the frog diagram of nervous system. Two first of all parts is the olfactory tract and olfactory lobe and cerebral hemispheres and pineal gland, diencephalon, and optic loop, cerebellum, and fourth ventricle. Last part of the medulla oblongata. Next, optic chiasma, hypothalamus, hypophysis. This is the frog nervous system of the diagram. We observe the frog nervous system diagram.
once again. First part is the olfactory tract, olfactory lobe, and cerebral hemisphere, and pineal gland, dynys apollon, and optic lobe, cerebellum, fourth ventricle, medulla oblongata, optica chiasma, and hypothalamus, hypophysis. This is the frog nervous system. Also, we see frog nervous system diagram, cerebrum, cerebellum, olfactory loop, optic loop, medulla oblongata, and spinal cord, and also we see spinal nerves. Okay, this is the frog have a highly developed nervous system that consists of a brain, spinal cord, and nerves. So many parts of the frog brains correspondent with those of humans. It consists of a two olfactory lobes, two cerebral hemispheres, a final body, and two optical lobes, a cerebellum and medulla oblongata. This is a part of the frog nervous system. Okay, and discussion again about the ventricles of brain, very most important of the parts. The cavity of the cavity enclosed by the brain is called a ventricle. There are four ventricles. There are four ventricles in the brain. They are 1, 2, 3, and 4. Four ventricles. First, we discuss